I'm back from the definition tour, which was mind-blowing and spectacular. It was dope. I love seeing you guys so much, and to see the fan base like grow to the level that it has is just such a blessing. You guys are like a supportive family, and it's incredible. But right before I had to start rehearsing for tour in New York with Beautiful Mind, I basically like had a few days to freely create, to challenge myself to like complete 3 records before heading back to the East Coast. I came up with an idea to choose like a random house in LA and rent it for a few days, like not like knowing what it looked like or anything. I didn't care if the place was like sound treated or whatever. I just wanted to get back to like grassroots, me and the craft, no outside opinions, like just having fun, no true objective, but to make like 3 dope songs and just release whatever I made, you know, to give you guys something before tour. I invited Dexter out to document the whole thing and see how it goes kind of thing. And he got a ton of footage of the process, and I just wanted to be able to speak to you guys during the documentary to like catch you up on my life in general, like post tour, and walk you through my thought process of these songs and get a little more personal. The records are obviously Woodstock, All Time Low, and Woke the F Up. And this is the footage of that experience. You are currently looking at my best friend / assistant / brother for absolute life. His name's Rob. We've been best friends since fourth grade, actually. That's crazy. He's gone above and beyond like my entire career to make sure I'm just like happy. He'll set up wherever we go, whatever house we're in, whatever studio we go to. He's already got it set up. It's already there because he knows like I don't want John to stress or anything. I just want his setup to be there. I just want him to be able to like freely create. I'll worry about everything else, and that's why he's just one of the most important people like to my success. I think I wouldn't even be a quarter as successful if it wasn't for him just in my corner supporting me constantly, like taking phone calls and just going above and beyond. So I love that dude. So this is like the random footage of me messing around when we first got to the house, and the house was so unapologetically 70s that I just started messing around with these chords, and it's kind of like how Woodstock got like birthed. I guess that was the first record. So this is me literally figuring out the chords. This is Woodstock. This is me literally just talking through. I'm just talking through my creativity. That's like a huge part of my process. So Rob's in the room just kind of like chilling, and he might be on his phone or whatever, but I'm in the zone. I need to literally tell somebody what I'm about to do just so I remember it, you know?
The originator of it, you know what I'm saying?
Right when I started beatboxing over those chords, I knew I already had the drum samples in my head, so I set them up and put them on the beat pad.
Relevant. You know what I mean? Says it's not like this dated, like this is a 70s throwback record. It's just like it's still really dope.
I'm convinced 9 times out of 10 Rob has no idea what I'm even saying or what I'm referring to, because I talk to him like he knows what I'm talking about. Like
awesome. It's like you go major on the chorus too, so everything starts on the minor. On she fell asleep during Coachella. Like, where are the minor?
I already kind of have how I'm going to approach the whole record, and I'm talking like he knows that too. It's like, he's probably just like, yeah. I just love to jam. I love to jam to get melody, so this is me just trying to find the proper verse melody.
That's a verse melody right there.
See, I'm literally finding where the melody could go, just kind of freestyling, seeing what comes naturally without having to like force it or try, you know? A lot of you guys don't see that. A lot of the process is me just kind of screwing around and like for hours of just jamming, because I love to just play music, so this is that. By this point, I knew exactly where the record was going.
Oh, oh, ah. Oh, oh, ah. Oh,
everybody
oh,
left, I think, to go get something to eat. So this is just gang vocals alone.
Oh, yeah, they
They all dropped acid cause the time was right. They all dropped acid cause the time was.
You could hear me sliding my voice. That's not how it is in the final record, because I'm constantly reworking sentences and seeing how to sing, with every tiny little difference makes such a difference in my brain. It's you know, an hour on one line just to see how to pronounce the last word of it or something. It's usually how it goes.
What's that? That shit went from to
little stuff like that gets me so excited. I've been making just noises. I used to make noises with my mouth when I was younger as placeholders for drums, and then I realized if I make the noise in pocket dope enough, it could add to the swing of the drums, like right here. See, everything's moving nicer now. Because of two simple, like, beatbox things, it's that easy.
What's that?
Here was, like, you know, the postal celebration. We made it. The record's done.
Oh, yeah, they. They all dropped acid because the time was right. Yeah, there was. Way too much magic in the air to fight. Yeah. They swear the grass is singing to them. They all dropped acid cause the time was right.
Here, what's that?
Bam. Mark coming in with that right there. Tomorrow,
what's that?
I'm gonna have him solo over this. Oh god, it's gonna be so stupid.
What's that?
Right back to that second verse. Yeah, just have him rip it. Just have him, like, just shred something over that. He's gonna body that. Put a real true 70s amp over it and just kind of give it that throwback feel. That'll be the only 70s-esque thing in there that's, like, true to the sound of that era. This is Mark Williams.
Damn, that's footage and everything, bro.
It's on top of things 24/7.
One of the most extraordinary, ridiculously, grossly gifted people on the planet in my humble opinion. One of the most talented, incredible dudes. He's like basically the transformer robotic arm I can attach on myself, because whatever I kind of fall short musically or playing wise or live wise, he just takes care of it. He's ridiculous. So amazing. So I'm realizing too, like, at later points in my career, I'm realizing that I get more joy out of even putting other people on, because it makes my product better, it makes the song better, and I also get to promote people that I just believe in. And he's one of those producers and talents that I'm just, like, blown away by, you know. And he actually is helping me on the post-tour album that I'm working on that is almost finished, so that's good news for everybody. I'll let you know now, but yeah, the album's almost done. He had a lot to do with it. He helped me throughout a lot of the album.
Throwback, because the guitar solo was going to be so advanced that it would be Hendrix-esque. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, shit.
Our workflow is amazing. He just understands what I, you know, the way I talk to Rob, I could talk to him, and him being an actual, like, you know, musician, it's easy for him to kind of understand. It took us months to get into that workflow, but now we work so well together. We're just like a well-oiled machine kind of thing, you know. He gets what I ask for. He's so talented that he could just do anything that I ask. He's incredible. Guess I just told you guys that the new album is 90% done. Honestly.
pepper just enough in that poster.
Oh, Lord.
I'm just sized in the background, just ready to go. I get so pumped seeing somebody talented. It gets, I guess, such a rise out of it. You know what I mean?
Dude, it's such a problem. This dude is such a problem.
I basically just loaded up the beat pad with a bunch of sounds, and it just happened to be great sound choices. I already had the drums once I heard that.
Ow.
I heard that thing, and I was like, oh, I could put that on top of the snare. Oh. Footage is super raw and like uncut, just because it didn't take long for me to make the song. It was I had the low concept first and then worked backwards. I found the low thing in my head. I kind of freestyled it, and once I loved it, I laid it down and then wrote the whole song backwards. Like, I had the low, didn't know where I was going with it, and then made all the lyrics match up to reach low conceptually. So I started with the chorus that didn't mean anything and just saying low, and then I figured out I'm at an all-time low. I don't know what that's gonna be, but that's the hook though. That's when the hook drops. It's just that moment, that musical moment. That Dilla swing, but you write a pop record on top of it. That, oh man. That's the melody. That's, oh man. As the first melody, I burn the nights and night in charms and in Austin. With pistolets, I'm not in love and I'm in them now. I'm the kids, don't darn it, kids, to sell not movie. Then I'm dip, I'm not in love. Oh, ride the pocket. But put your lips on mine and love the aftertaste. And that would be the rhyme. Aftertaste, at the late, past the bait. I would love to, oh man. Masturbate. On some like Billy Joel. What is he saying that? Was that Captain Jack? You gonna sit at home and you sit at home and watch porno mags and masturbate or something? I remember hearing that when I was a kid and being like, did he just say, like, masturbate on a record? I've been trying to fix my property that's just broken. Lila Lie. I try to hide, but now you know. But the Lila Lie, like a Simon and Garfunkel reference. So you got the Billy Joel, you know, it reminds me of Billy Joel using that masturbate line. Then you also got the Lila Lie from the boxer, Simon and Garfunkel. So yeah, it was me finding the low and then just working from the first verse to get to the low to make it all make sense. Such a cruise right through that.
I was the knight in shining armor in your movie. Would put your lips on mine and love the aftertaste now. I'm a ghost, I call your name, you look right through me. You're the reason I'm alone and...
As interesting as I would hope for it to be, all-time low was just that fast. It finished in half a day. I had an extra day to work, so I could have worked or I could have played basketball, but I chose to play basketball. Random side note, I don't get to speak my mind a lot, so I'm going to start using these videos to kind of just tell you guys how I feel about other things besides music. A lot of people ask me on my Twitter and stuff, why isn't he bigger? Why? I can't wait for him to blow up. I can't wait for him to blow up. I heard him on here. I heard him on here. It's only a matter of time. To be honest, I like living my life. I like being able to play basketball. I like spending time with my family. I don't mind being an average Joe, so I don't necessarily know if I want to be Justin Bieber getting his head ripped off in a mall. I don't even think he necessarily chose that life. It gets taxing as an artist, if I could just speak honestly. Like, it's just taxing. I don't want to show the world my life all the time. I don't want to owe the world a selfie or, you know, owe the world anything. I did this because I love making music. I just love making music. That's just one of the things I like to do. I don't ever want to let it ruin my life or consume me or get me to a point where I don't know who I am anymore. And I spend my whole life chasing something and look back and my niece has grown up and my sisters are older and everybody's kind of just, you know, we still love you, but we miss you, we miss you, we miss you. I don't want to be missed forever. I don't want to go on tour forever. I mean, that's just how I feel. That doesn't mean I'm not going to be putting out music and I'm not going to be moving my career forward, but the music just doesn't rule my life. So I do get torn between being the most fashionable, always making sure I'm on top of my Twitter and answering fans and doing things. It's like, I don't necessarily want to do that forever. The music is important to me and I love making it. And if I change the course of music and I'm the new guy on the block that's killing the industry, that's fine, but it's not my God. It doesn't define me. My musical success doesn't define me at all. So I'm chilling. God's blessed me with immense talent. I understand that. And wonderful. If it takes me somewhere and it helps me make some money to provide and to bless other people, then and that's what I'm supposed to do, awesome. But I'm not losing sleep about it. I'm just not. Either way, God's in control. Just bring my vocal up just a little bit if you can. Yeah, that's gonna be dope. Yes, dude, just a quick run through just to see how it feels.
Want to, yeah, I want to. Take your clothes and rip them off. Call these hoes and tip them off. You can tell them you are mine. I'm sick of games. No more time, you lit the flame. 'Cause we live in an age where everything is staged and all we do is fake our feelings. I'm so scared to put myself so out there. Time is running out, yeah. need to let you know. That last night I woke the fuck up. I realized I need you here, as desperate as that sounds, yeah, yeah. Last night I woke the fuck up. I realized I need you here, as desperate as that sounds, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, let me take him to the second verse. That's gonna be dope.